great marijuana?
That is the purpose of this meeting, ladies and gentlemen.
Marijuana is referred to as Mary Jane, pot, weed, or tea.
Let me chew a gun, man. Acapulco gold, man. I even smoke that tight stick.
We're smoking reefer.
The weirdest thing smoking on the internet. Potheads
web show.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. It's 4:20 on a Wednesday, and you're in the Cypher with the Podheads. As always, I'm your Commander-in-Chief, your Sherpa up the Mountain of Highness, Frank the Tank, hanging with my very best buds, J.B. Perez.
Yeah, what's up? As always, we're the Podheads Web Show, at the Podheads Web Show, on all the social media platforms. WJHM102jams.com. That's our main page. That's where you're listening to us right now. Thank you very much. Yeah, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter. I'm at PotheadsJB on that stuff too. And we got another great show for you guys today, so I'm excited. So let's get to it. See money.
Hello, everybody. Thanks for tuning in another week with us. I don't even know what episode this is. 31?
32?
32,
I believe.
32? Wow.
Yeah. I've lost count.
Pretty amazing.
Huffing and puffing.
Yeah. At Megan C. Money for all your food needs, anything and everything related to food. Let's get it going, boys.
Yeah. It's going to be an awesome one, guys. Welcome back, as usual, to the Cypher. We're doing our thing. We're going to talk the latest in, I don't know, urban fashion, celebrity fashion.
Yeah, men. That's what they call it. Yeah. Progressive men's fashion.
Yeah. Guys are painting their nails. All right, folks. And not only guys, but little kids too, little boys. And we want to know what the guys with the buds think and what you guys think about this latest fashion. We'll get into that in a second, though. I did want to do this as we always do, gentlemen, because, I mean, what are we if we aren't the Podheads?
So let's get to it. I go first because this is literally the last of it right here, guys. The last of my wax.
Last of the wax.
This was called, I believe, bubblegum. Just straight up bubblegum. It's good. Dude. I'm actually kind of glad I'm running out because you do get used to it. So it does lose its effect. The concentrates. I've been on my concentrates binge now for a few months. And it's kind of slowly dwindling down. So I guess I'm going back to the flower very soon, and I'm actually kind of excited because this is kind of like it's just not hitting that well anymore. So
yeah, I'll come back.
Here's the last of it, guys.
The grass is greener on this side, pun intended. Somebody, what are you smoking on?
I 'tis the season, I guess. pays to be nice to people because later on you never know how they repay you back. So my buddy's been hooking me up. Some things have been tight lately. So anything he has that's kind of been sitting on the shelf, or if he has something new that he wants a little review on, he lets me just kind of lets me try or have. So shout out to that dude. It's called Sunday Driver. So never heard of that strand. Sure, it's great, but it tastes good on the pens. But yeah, I feel the same way. In fact, before the show started, JB and I were talking about how, you know, I see videos of these people doing edibles and stuff, and they're just like, bro, I was good for hours, and I'm just like, every 10 minutes I could hit this 90% pen.
Yeah.
You know, like
for real.
Speaking of that, is anybody else sick of the chicks on Instagram in like bikinis or t-shirt and panties just smoking, like not doing anything, nothing hot, nothing interesting, just taking taking a drag off a joint or hitting a bong or something?
Frank the Tanks bring this up at least, if not every other episode, every third episode, because he really feels strongly about this. I'm with you, Frank the Tank. Yeah, it is so annoying. You're not doing anything. You're not saying anything. Quote unquote Instagram models here.
Yeah, I wish I had.
Terrible.
Things. We'd be really.
The motivational quotes are horrible too. It's a chick looking all hot, and there's a motivational quote beneath it. I don't understand. Like never giving up and saying positive blah, blah, blah. Like, what the hell does that have to do with you in a bikini? I don't get it. They just use every excuse to use that poor, poor grip of sexuality that society has. I mean, I feel like people are so suppressed that anything sexual is just such a eye grabber. I mean, imagine if people had sex more often. it wouldn't be such a, oh my God, look at this.
You know what? I think there's a point to that. Really, we could talk about that for another episode. Maybe we will. But that's a good point because I think you're right.
Kind of the theme of the year, 2019, is all about that fake life. That social media, right? We had Zuckerberg sitting at Congress for Pete's sake a few months back. 2019 has been all about social media, all about the appearance that people are putting out there. And since we're here towards the, this is one of the last episodes of the season, of the year. And it just, it's funny to sit there and reflect and think about how much BS has been filtered through Facebook, Instagram in the last few, so many years, even stuff that has even affected the way we see politics, right? I was just mentioning Zuckerberg and how they got in trouble because they were putting out political ads. You know, they got accused of actually putting out ads for certain political parties and not others. Don't want to get too much into that, but I just think it's interesting how the grip that social media has had on the public this year, and I hope to God it's over. Please, people, find something else. The Masked Singer, have yo-yos come back. I don't know, but something other than social media.
I'm reminded of a quote. Once technology surpasses humanity, man, we're screwed, and I feel like we're there already. What are we talking about this show?
We're talking about the new trend, right? I don't know who it started with. Okay, Bad Bunny, Alicia Keys' son, Jaden Smith. I don't know. But men everywhere are starting to wear nail polish on their fingers. And it's causing kind of a stir in Hollywood and in at dinner tables all over the U.S., right? It's starting to get more popular every month. It's nothing new that happened this year, but if you're into social media, you've seen on Instagram, by the way, Instagram at the Podheads Web Show. Don't forget to look for us and follow us there. But you've seen Alicia Keys getting on Instagram and complaining about how she puts a picture up of her kid with nail polish, and people start talking smack. Well, she then makes a big deal saying, you know, how dare you people? I can't believe people are so ignorant that they would come at a kid on social media or come at me over allowing my kid to wear nail polish. Dwayne Wade had to come to the defense of his kid because he was seen wearing a nail polish in pictures on social media. You know the artist Bad Bunny, who is an avid nail polish wearer. And there's a bunch of other celebrities. Neil Patrick Harris. I mean, whether you think it's a gay thing or not, there's a lot of people doing it. I wanted to get your guys' thoughts because I don't know. I'm kind of on the fence, but I want to know how you guys think. What side of the fence you guys sit on this?
Yeah, I think the side of the fence, because I thought of it. I knew we were going to talk about this, and I've actually thought about this, and I'm still kind of debating, not riding the fence, but trying to understand both sides. Because I'm all for freedom of expression, and you got your style, you should flaunt it, be your best self, live your best. And if one of those choices for your best life is to decide to wear, you know, yellow nail polish or blue or purple, okay, so be it. That's fine. Personally, to answer your question, long-winded story here, no, I personally would not wear it. I would feel a certain way if I had a child who would wear it. So big ups for Dwayne Wade for, you know, kind of standing up to his son. I probably would not be as supportive, maybe internally, but it's a different way of the world, man. It's a different way of the world.
It is. That's exactly the point I was going to make. It is so different now because I can imagine, like, if my uncle wore nail polish when he was, you know, I don't know, 10 or 15, mm-hmm. and my grandfather, who was like this hardened war vet, mm-hmm. built everything by hand, alpha male of a guy, I couldn't imagine the things he would say to him.
Right.
Now, what are you, a Mary, you know, you this and that and all that. And that's just being nice. So he would say horrible things because that was just a different time.
Right? He would probably get his ass beat,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, he would probably get his ass beat, too.
And that's exactly what I'm saying. Our generation, the millennials, are in that transition point where we're like, we understand it, but maybe half of us personally would not allow it or wouldn't do it themselves. But we're millennials, bro. We, you know, we allow everybody to do whatever makes them happy. And then the future generations, like we're saying, Jaden Smith does it. Dwayne Wade's sons, the younger generation sees that as, oh, that's cool, that's cute, I like that style, I'm gonna do it. They don't think twice about it, so it'll be normal for them. So even the question, the discussion for them isn't even there. It's a fashion statement to them. To us, it's just like, are you gay? What are you doing? Like, what's going on over here, right?
I think maybe also it has something to do with, I don't know if this started as like a rich person, more or less, trend. And if it did, maybe there, I mean, I can't just imagine being, I don't care either, do whatever makes you happy, life is short, as long as you're not hurting somebody else. But I can't imagine being so bored or having nothing else to worry about in my life to be staring at my nails one day to be like, I should paint these.
You weren't a smoke kid. You didn't paint your nails black. You look like
That's funny you said that too. I was emo and I didn't do nail polish, but that I understood because you wore all black. And you wore black on your nails, I guess, to match. Like, that's the kind of thing I get.
Okay,
but that's what
so
I mean. But imagine
yellow to match their sneaker.
But I also feel like, this is what happens when you don't have to hunt for your own food or chop your own firewood like our ancestors. You have time to worry about things like this. I don't think struggling families in inner cities are worrying about, you know, nail polish. That's all I'm saying. But whatever makes you happy, man, go for it. You know,
true.
And you know what? I want to talk more about this, but we're running out of time for this. And I want to come back and talk backlash and repercussions about this. Like, is there a line or should there be a line? And where is it if there is? But like I said, we do got to get to break real quick. Shout out to the guys over at WJHM 102 Jams for making this happen. Make sure you check out our show on the website. All of our episodes are up there. Look for us everywhere you get our get your podcast at the Podheads web show. That's PODHEADS. We'll be right back with more on
progressive men's fashion. I mean, what are
more
we
on progressive
about?
Men's fashion or toxic masculinity? We'll be right back with the Podheads.
Hey guys, this is TC1, and when I stay in Orlando, I like to stay at the Quality Suites over on International Drive. They are amazing property, simple rooms in an all-suite hotel with outdoor pool, a restaurant, plus free Wi-Fi and a shuttle. Guys, give them a call at 407-363-0332. They're located at 7400 Canada Ave, Orlando, Florida, 32819.
Mid-State Fire has been providing top-quality fire equipment services for 3 generations to the Central Florida area. Don't wait for an emergency to repair. Call Mid-State Fire today at 407-246-8855. Get your fire extinguishers and emergency lighting for both your home and businesses by visiting www.midstatefire.com. That number again is 407-246-8855. The Tribute Show would like to thank one of our dedicated sponsors, Custom Designs Orlando. These guys are on Mills Avenue and do all sorts of stuff, ranging from photo ID badges, engraved signs, custom Braille ADA signs, vinyl lettering, to trophies and awards. They can ship products all over the United States. You can reach them at 407-898-0373. The Tribia Show would like to thank Boggy Creek Airboat Adventures for being one of our sponsors. I got to go on an airboat and saw a real gator. I even got to go to the gem mine and mine for some gems. We ate a steak dinner at the restaurant and even got some gator bites. If you want to have a blast with the entire family, I suggest you go to www.bcairboats.com right now. Get your tickets today. The website again is bcairboats.com.
The Podheads web show presents Pioneers in Pot. Jack Harrer. A head shop owner early in his career, Jack Herer is widely known for his efforts to decriminalize cannabis and expand the use of hemp for industrial use. Made popular by the success of his best-selling book, The Emperor Wears No Clothes, a compilation of facts and figures surrounding cannabis as it relates to culture, commerce, and politics, Herer has been an influential figure in the legal cannabis movement since 1985. As an activist, he argued that cannabis should be legalized and taught how hemp could be used as a renewable source of fuel. Much of his work continues to be cited in cannabis rescheduling and legalization efforts today. There's also a pretty good strain named after him that is popular to date. Put one in the air for Jack Herer, a true pioneer in pot. All right, you're back in the cipher with the Podheads. Thank you for sticking with us, people, at the Podheads web show, all over social media. Check out our Twitter, our Instagram, Facebook. We're all over there. We need the support. We love the support. We want to keep doing this for you in the best way possible. Yes, at the Podheads web show. That's P-O-D-H-E-A-D-S. Guys, let's continue this. Let's continue this conversation because I wanted to get into the real thing about this, right? We can talk all day about whether it's taboo or not, but when does it become bullying, right, for people to start now getting on these kids' cases for not being normal or not following the status quo? And should these people or should these parents really go ahead and are they really justified in feeling some kind of way about people expressing their confusion or their discontent with these people wearing this? I mean, if I'm walking down the street in a dress, should I have any right to feel some kind of way if people are looking at me weird?
Right. I mean, so I think it depends on which side of the fence you're on, because if you're attacking your kid, let's just take Dwayne Wade's position, right? I as a parent of a little, you know, of a child too, I know I'm going to be supportive in any way, in any fashion of my own child. Okay, so if he wants to wear nail polish, and you know that's what he wants to do, I'm going to be supportive. It's just the way. It's what you have to do with your children, especially. It's just what you have to do, but if I was on the other side, I would be confused. You said bullying. You should never come at not only kid in a bully fashion, but in any way, you shouldn't come with negative attitude or with just a you can't come at it with a negative attitude, but you can ask the question, like, why are you allowing this? Because it isn't norm. It isn't societal norms. Okay, it's not evil to ask the question, right? It's not wrong to ask the question.
Well, here's the thing. When you're living in La La Land, okay, when you're rich and your kids never have to worry about a cent for the rest of their lives, then sure, mm-hmm. You want to let them run around in a tutu and pretend they're a fairy? That's all fine and well. But for the rest of us in the real world, there are certain societal norms that if one is expected to land a good job or quote unquote make it through whatever, you know, make it through high school, college, whatever, without too much stress and successful without too much people coming down on them, you know, you would kind of try and, I mean, think about it. You're not rich. If your little kid says, oh my God, I want to wear nail polish like mom does, what are you going to tell them? No, that's what girls do. So, you know, is that bad? Are you now hindering your kid's self-expression? You know what I mean? Are you a bad parent for correcting that behavior? Or are these celebrities bad parents for not kind of reining their kids in? You know what I mean?
We all want to live in this utopian world where we all are acceptive of everybody who, you know, whatever they want to be. But in the real world, in society, it's not that easy. Dwayne Wade's son probably doesn't deal with the bullying that an inner city kid would deal with if he wore the exact same outfit. I see on Twitter and Instagram and on all the news, kids killing themselves because of bullying, okay? Just because they're fat or just because they have curly hair or freaking freckles, okay? You understand? So you make a very good point there, Frank the Tank. But you also remind me of another good point that makes of another good point. It's not only society, but cultural. Okay, the Latinos, Bad Bunny, he's from Puerto Rican. I don't know how he grew up, but I know in the men's way of thinking, the Latino way of thinking, the machismo there, right? We're boxers. We're hard workers, right? We don't wear makeup. We don't wear...
It's very masculine.
We're very masculine. We don't cry. We fight to the death, right? So what he's doing is very controversial, especially for him.
Well, he got denied service in a nail salon in Spain because they told him, hey, you're a man. I'm not going to paint your nails.
There you go.
So there's an example.
So there you go. So who's in the wrong, right? Are they wrong for denying service in a culture where they don't do that, right? He's not in America, right? It's in Italy. They don't do that over there. So are they wrong?
I want C-Money's take on this. C-Money, do celebrities have the right to feel any kind of way? I lean towards no. If you're going to put pictures of your kids up on social media, doing all kinds of things, hey, if you want to be a snowflake, that's fine. Do what you want to do. But at least expect people to react if you're doing something different. Do they have a right to then lash back at the public for expressing their feelings towards how weird it is or how they perceive it?
Well, what's weird is that nail polish and a lot of makeup actually was invented in ancient Egypt, naturally, right? And the ironic thing is the... nail polish was often used to signify class, and lower classes would use more of a dull, light color, whereas a rich class would use, I guess, like hardcore red. And what's ironic is that, you know, it's the upper class normally that starts these crazy trends and odd outfits that's considered normal, I guess, to society. It's just weird how anything is really considered normal, right? Because it had to originate from a group of people or something one day to say, hey, this is what boys do and this is what girls do, because there you go. In ancient China, everyone wore it. So who's to say it's male or female? That's just what society does. But no, man, in this whole idea of do whatever makes you happy as long as you're not hurting anybody else and we all need to get along, you technically going along with that, you should be able to do whatever you want. But again, these celebrities, bro, they do also live in a different reality. I mean, look at Lady Gaga. I think she's a talented person, but the outfits she wears are crazy, right, to some. But, I mean, Leonardo da Vinci was also a very creative person, and there's one thing I don't remember is him having crazy, crazy outfits like that. So, you know, because that's what people say. Oh, well, they're creative people.
They claim it's fashion, right? So is it that? Are they as artists, okay, as rich people in the art entertainment, are they doing this to stand out, to gain attention?
Probably.
We're in the middle of another renaissance in fashion. Is that what we're saying? I mean, we had men wearing heels back in the 1800s. You said people wore nail polish and makeup to signify their wealth.
It's kind of been a thing for a while, though. I mean, even like Prince and all them, you know, they wore nail polish and high heels and all, you know what I mean? So I feel like throughout the decades, it's always kind of been a thing on the back side. But it's ironic because back then, someone like Prince would wear nail polish and high heels, and he would get more chicks than any guy at that time. But that's considered gay. You know, it's so ironic. So what's to say it's, you know, just let the person do whatever they want. But yeah, let's be honest, man, those people are probably bored. And what better way to get attention is to just stir up drama? I mean, when you don't have to work every day, man, that's a crazy life.
I mean, I think they all, I mean, every headline that I saw, Dwayne Wade was talking about inclusivity. It's the gender question, right? Gender inclusivity, gender norms, gender this, gender that, right? Boys can be girls, girls can be boys, and everything in between and outside of the lines there too. So it's like, you know, we're all confused. I don't know what's right or wrong. Every other week, there's another gender that I have to be cognizant of, right?
Yeah, I mean, like, does that work in a society? Does that work where people just let everybody look? Let everybody do what they want as long as they're not hurting anybody else. I mean, where's the line? Should there be a line on something like that?
Well, that...
Yes, there's like over 50. I kid you not. There's over 50 pronouns now. Over 50. Come on.
For genders, like right?
Yeah, him, her, and zer, and zim, and all that. There's over 50. Like, I don't think society. Yeah, I don't think society will let that take, because your average person, if you ask the average person what's your pronoun, they would look at you like, what the hell? What are you talking about?
Yeah, I think the LGBT community is a real community. But all that zin, zan, zoon, I think that stems from freedom of speech and social media and attention. And again, I'm no gender expert at all, but know there's men, female, and people who are opposite, and that's it. There's nothing else, man. Either you like boys, or you like girls, or both.
Right. Yeah, I mean, I didn't mean to veer off onto that path. I mean, again, I'm do whatever makes you happy. And I understand why those people in all those groups need to feel like they voice their opinion, because they've been suppressed. And now they have outlets like social media to voice their opinion. I mean, imagine being a person who's kind of been sheltered and couldn't really come out of their closet. And now all of a sudden you have a platform that could reach potentially millions of people everywhere. That's a very useful tool to someone like that. And I get it, man. Do your thing. But another rabbit hole is, think about it, religion is usually the reason why someone can't come out for X amount of reasons, you know, especially in a family. I mean, think of how many people are probably can't come out of their closet because their parents are super religious, especially in this country. That sucks, man. I feel bad for those people, for sure.
That's definitely down the rabbit hole. We all smile.
Yeah, man.
Oh, man. Yeah, man. I think I guess the taboo is becoming the norm these days. That's needless to say. I just feel like, I don't know. There's a side to me that wants to know where it all ends before we end up falling off the cliff. But maybe that's just me being an old bastard. I don't know. We'll find out. But stay tuned, guys. We got to take a break. When we come back, we're going to have some higher learning. So stay right there. We'll be right back. It's the pod. All I want to do is get my nails done. That's all I want to do. That's all I want to do. All I want to do is get my nails done. That's all I want to do. That's all I want to do. It's Sunday afternoon. I got one thing on my mind. Manicure, pedicure. My nails looking fine. Luscious berry on my fingertips. Nail polish and brush. I come equipped. My favorite cut lined up in a row. Nail polish on my fingers and toes. After I get my croissants pressed on, put my nails in the dryer and then I'm gone. All I want to do is get my nails done.
Aw, Dad, my computer's slow again and I can't play my games.
Call Your Computer Solutions today and we will scan for viruses and clean that computer up remotely and make it fast again. Our phone number is 407-826-0810.
Thanks, Dad. My computer's fast again. Now I can do my homework. Thanks for calling Your Computer Solutions at 407-826-0810. See, David Smith, law.com.
You can call him at 407-801-2667.
Wait, you are not Chuck.
My dad can help when people get hurt. He loves to help people.
If you are ever injured at work or in a car accident, you should call my friend Chuck.
You can call him at 407-801-2667.
That website again is cwsmithlaw.com.
Offices, Orlando.
Does it actually have that much W's?
The Ted Beard Show would like to thank one of our awesome sponsors, SlutChannelUS.com. These guys are very, very cool. They bring 21st century surface drainage solutions to reality. They can do corporate and government work. These are the guys that make roads and bridges safe in the rain. You can see all about them at SlutChannelUS.com. That website again is SlutChannelUS.com. Oak Ridge Gun Range is a family-oriented shooting range that has been in business for over 30 years. They specialize in basic firearm training and offer numerous services such as consignments, gun trades, gunsmithing, and concealed weapon classes. I even got my training for gun safety at Oak Ridge Gun Range. Great customer service, and firearm safety is what they do best. So find out more at OakRidgeGunRange.com.
All right, you're back in the cipher with the Podheads. It's JB Perez here with my best buds. We're at the Podheads Web Show on all the social media platforms. Once again, thank you so much for listening. And let's keep the show on. Before we get going with Higher Learning, Frank the Tank's awesome segment there, it's actually my turn for the drug screening. So let's get to it, guys. Hashtag the drug screening.
Did you ever see Scent of a Woman?
Yup.
You ever seen Scent of a Woman on weed?
You may have seen him before, but you've never seen him like this. We've scoured the archives in search of some of the worst movies just to bring you the hidden nugs that were made better by Bud. The Podheads Web Show presents The Drug Screening.
Hashtag the drug screening, where the Podheads bring you the terrible movies, right? The movies that just kind of suck, terrible ratings, but are just a little bit better with a little bit of cannabis. And I think this one really does fit the bill because this movie's terrible. But I ended up laughing a little bit because I was baked. And that's Night at the Roxbury, guys. I'm sure you've all seen it. I think C-Money told me that, what, maybe you haven't seen it?
Been like 10, 15 years.
it's been a long time. Yeah, recently came across it. And yeah, it's a pretty terrible movie. Not only the critics say it was terrible, 11% out of Rotten Tomatoes. Yeah, pretty terrible. And the critics, of course, killed it. It's an SNL movie, right? It stars a young Will Ferrell and Chris Kattan. They're SNL characters, and if you know the early SNL show, there was a duo, Steve and Doug, right? They were brothers, the Butabi brothers, and they were just these young, rich children of wealth a little bit who just like to party, like to go to the club and try to hit on women and get women, and that's pretty much the movie, and that's the joke. So that's why it kind of sucks, because there is only one joke. These two guys are just kind of idiots, and they kind of kept the joke going. But it's a little. But when you're baked, of course, you kind of get into the soundtrack of the movie. What is love? Right. So you get into it, and you end up watching the whole movie. So again, long story short, definitely be blazed to watch Night at the Roxbury, because it is a long 80 minutes of the same joke. These two losers trying to get laid at clubs and then having a breakup because one wants to get married or something or other. Anyways, hashtag the drug screening, Night at the Roxbury. Get baked. Watch it. Let us know what's up. Let's do it.
Yeah. Great movie. You know, that's another one with a good cast that is slept on. But you got to kind of be in the know. These movies don't make sense to anybody who's not a fan of SNL. You know what I mean? And if you don't know what he's talking about, it's the two guys in, like, the suits who are basically humping, you know, the chick in between them, going back and forth, bouncing back and forth off them. And, you know, so it's a funny... It's a movie about based off that skit, and it's pretty damn funny. I like it. So I'm all in. I haven't seen that movie in years, JB, but I think for like a lazy Sunday, I'm all in. Roll up a blunt and watch Night at the Roxbury. Oh, man. All right, so look, I'm going to take it here and get into my segment. It's been a while. You guys know we've been doing this a little differently lately, but I've got some Higher Learning for you. So today we're going to put these two fine gentlemen on the spot with some Podheads trivia. End of 2019 edition.
I like it.
Can't just say I'm smaller you, smaller you, smaller you. Can't just say I'm smart.
All right, guys, I've got 10 questions here to see how well you've been paying attention to the year 2019. Basically, these questions are all based on the biggest headlines of the year. Let's see who's been sleeping and who's woke. All right. So far, I think JB is undefeated on Potheads Trivia, by the way.
Yeah, it's been a while since we've done any trivia, so I'm really excited. I don't remember who won last. I know I've won the most, so I'm pretty confident I'll win again. So let's do it.
If there was a game show, it would not be a trivia-based game show like this that I would choose. So this is why, if people are wondering why JB has won so often, I would have to be on, like, a Legends of the Hidden Temple, the Family Double Dare type obstacle game. That is where, or Guts. You guys remember?
I loved Guts, bro. That was my, oh man.
Climbing the crag, that would have been my forte, man. Yeah.
I swore on everything that I would own that show if I could just get on it.
Get on it.
Yeah.
All right, gentlemen. Let's see how well you guys know the year. Let's go. All right, first question. Some of these are going to be, and this is stoner stuff, so it's not going to be very organized. And but most of them are going to be multiple choice. All right. Alongside with Lori Loughlin, this Desperate Housewives actress was brought up on charges for bribery and fraud in an attempt to raise her kids' SAT scores. She ended up doing 14 days in prison. Okay, here are your options. Mm-hmm. Zooey Deschanel, Felicity Huffman, Snooki, or Margaret Simpson.
Simone, I'll let you go first.
One name stood out to me, but give me the names one more time. Zooey
Deschanel.
Hung up on one of those names.
Zooey Deschanel, Felicity Huffman, Snooki, and Margaret Simpson.
Just because I dislike her and I hope it's her, Snooki.
JB?
Snooki, Felicity Huffman's my final answer. Yes. You know who Snooki is, C-Money?
Yeah, of course I do. I can't stand her. They made millions of dollars each, those bastards, for partying.
No, she did not get caught up in the education scandal.
Oh, that's hilarious.
I mean,
that was supposed to be my obvious no. Alright, here we go.
It may be, in my defense, it may be a horrible thing to say, but I can't really imagine her creating a smart spawn, so it would make sense for her to be paying her kids way through school. Just saying. Please, to hell with those people.
Alright, here we go. Who is the father of this prince that was born this year on May 6th. The kid's name, all right, is Archie Harrison Manbounth Windsor. Who's
I don't
the
understand
father?
The question, first of all. I don't know that creepy-ass name.
On May 6th, a prince was born. The prince's name was Archie Harrison. All right? The father is either A, Prince Harry, B, Prince Charles, C, Prince Richard, or D, Prince Darling. Excuse me, Prince Charming. Come on, I'll make it easy for you.
I'll go first. I'm going to go with B. I believe that was Prince Charles.
All right. JB says B, Prince Charles. C, Money. Is it Prince Harry, Prince Charles, Prince Stuart, or Prince Charming?
I mean, I don't want to get the same one as JB.
You shouldn't.
I'm going with C. It's probably wrong, but Stuart. So I like Stuart.
Prince, like King Harry. Stuart.
Prince Harry. Yes, Harry. I knew as soon as I said the answer, I was wrong.
Oh, man.
See, I haven't followed the royals since Diana, man. A candle floating in the wind. You know?
All right. Okay. And early this year, a documentary came out exposing R. Kelly for all his shame and drama, bringing all the girls that he quote unquote raped to light.
Remember.
Name this documentary. Was it A, Leaving R. Kelly? B, R. Kelly's Sex Cult? C, Surviving R. Kelly? Or D, Surviving Neverland?
C, that's my answer.
Yes, I have to agree. It is C.
Both guys say C, and that's correct. Yeah. That's correct.
Every single title would match perfectly, though, because, it's terrible what that man did.
All right, here we go. In the spring of 2019, Kim Kardashian announced that she was nearly through a four-year apprenticeship to become one of these professionals. A, an engineer. B, a doctor. C, a lawyer. Or D, a clothing designer.
I'm going to go with C. We've talked about it several times.
C, money? Do you agree?
Porn star wasn't on the list, so I'm going with C. That's a terrible joke, by the way.
Right. Hey, you guys both got it right. Listen, we got to take a quick break. We're going to come back and finish this quiz here and find out which one of these guys can pass the test. Will C Money dethrone JB, or does he's got another 12 rounds in him? Find out when we come back. We'll be right back.
Yeah, it's all me, baby. Somehow, maybe it is Paul's fault that we're all here together, because if it wasn't for Paul, I would not have met Frank, and they would have never, you know, and here we are 15 years later.
The butterfly effect.
Mm-hmm.
Man, if it wasn't for weed, I wouldn't have met any of you.
Right.
Yes, I would see money's drug dealer.
Yeah. Weed, laughs, and more on the Podheads web show. Check us out on Wednesdays at 7 p.m. on WJHM102jams.com.
Mid-State Fire has been providing top-quality fire equipment services for three generations to the Central Florida area. Don't wait for an emergency to repair. Call Mid-State Fire today at 407-246-8855. Get your fire extinguishers and emergency lighting for both your home and businesses by visiting www.midstatefire.com. That number again is 407-246-8855. Over 40 years, Lighthouse Central Florida has provided education, independent life skills, and job training to thousands of Central Floridians who live with blindness or any degree of vision loss. Whether it's picking out clothes in the morning or just moving around your community and serving Orange, Seminole, and Osceola counties, contact Lighthouse Central Florida at 407-898-2483 or visit them online at lighthousecfl.org. The Tribute Show would like to thank one of our dedicated sponsors, Custom Designs Orlando. These guys are on Mills Avenue and do all sorts of stuff, ranging from photo ID badges, engraved signs, custom Braille ADA signs, vinyl lettering, to trophies and awards. They can ship products all over the United States. You can reach them at 407-898-0373. The Tribio Show would like to thank Boggy Creek Airboat Adventures for being one of our sponsors. I got to go on an airboat and saw a real gator. I even got to go to the gem mine and mine for some gems. We ate a steak dinner at the restaurant and even got some gator bites. If you want to have a blast with the entire family, I suggest you go to www.bcairboats.com right now. Get your tickets today. The website again is bcairboats.com.
Hey everybody, welcome to another edition of Sea Munchies. Thank you for joining me. Tis the season, as we are in the holiday season, my favorite time of the year, because that is comfort food. And if you've been sticking with me here on the show during hashtag Sea Munchies, I've been giving you comfort recipes. And right along, I'm going to give you another one. This is what my family makes. We are Sicilians, and this actually dates back to ancient Rome. This is wassail. And if you don't know what that is, it is a delicious hot drink that makes you feel all warm and fuzzy inside. So delicious, and it's cider-based. So what you're going to need is 1 gallon of your favorite apple cider, 4 cups of your favorite orange juice, 10 cinnamon sticks, 1 teaspoon of whole cloves, 1 tablespoon of juniper berries, 1.5 inches of fresh ginger cut into thin slices, 1 whole apple, I like to use Granny Smith because it adds a little tartness, and 1 whole orange. You're going to slice both those fruits up into rounds. I also like to add a little cinnamon, gives it an extra kick. Cinnamon's super good for you, and it is just delicious. Goes great with cider and apples. And that's it, guys. You're going to put the ingredients into a slow cooker, turn it on high, and cook it for about 3 to 4 hours until the color is darkened a little bit and the fruit is nice and soft. And once it's done, guys, serve it in a mug. So delicious, hot, comforting, tasty, sweet, and tart. Amazing wassail for you guys. Let me know how you like it at Making Sea Money, hashtag Sea Munchies. Till next time, guys.
Okay, great. We're back. Thanks, guys. Thank you, Sea Money. Another great edition of Sea Munchies. Let's get this quiz over again. We're right in the middle of Podheads Trivia on this edition of hashtag Higher Learning. So far, JB is in the lead, 3-2. It's a close one. Can Sea Money come back in this one?
Nope.
All right. I don't know. Yeah, his guess about Snooki being involved in the college scandal was kind of suspect. See, Mighty,
he let his emotions get a hold of him too much there.
You got frazzled? You got frazzled. All right, here we go. Next question. This Empire actor claimed that he was a victim of a hate crime in Chicago, where 2 white supremacists threw a noose around his neck and beat him up, right? Name this actor. Was it A, Omar Epps, B, Jesse Smollett, C, Terrence Howard, or D, Taraji P. Henson? See money.
Going with B, Juicy Smollett. Yes, that bastard.
JB agrees. All right.
Yeah, I do agree. You know, he's trying to sue back the cops for, like, you know, whatever, some BS trying to wake him up.
No judge is going to entertain that. They're going to be like, all right, buddy.
Yeah. All right, next question. Highly popular West Coast rapper was unfortunately gunned down in front of his own clothing store on March 31st of this year. Name this rapper. Was it A, Too Short, B, Tekashi 69, I wish, C, Nipsey Hussle, or D, Kodak Black?
See, money, I'll let you go first.
I went first last one. I ain't going first.
You're confident. I don't want you to steal my answer.
Maybe you're stealing my answer.
Okay. You're right. I'll go first. I'll say Nipsey Hussle.
All right. You can curse your money.
I mean, yeah, you're right. It does kind of seem like... I mean, Tekashi surprisingly isn't shot yet. I don't understand how. But yeah, Nipsey. I see it all over Twitter still to this day. It's...
There you go, Nipsey. All right.
Nipsey.
Awesome. We got JB in the lead, 5-4. It's still close, guys. We need a tiebreaker here. Here we go.
Let's need a question out of left field so I can catch up.
All right, I got one for you. Just in the nick of time, because I'm not sure we ever talked about this, but I just heard about this in the news. This country music legend and definite pioneer pop, he is synonymous with cannabis, recently came out saying that he is no longer smoking marijuana.
What?
Now, is it A, Garth Brooks, B, Willie Nelson, C, Jack Herer, or D, Darius Rucker? JB, you look confused, so I'm going to let you go first.
Yeah, I know. I recognize all of those names. The only cannabis smoker in that list that I am sure of is Willie Nelson. But I... Now, if... Hey, what are you, 90? Now you're going to stop smoking if you're Willie Nelson? Like... I'm going to go Willie Nelson, though.
JB says Willie Nelson. See money.
Yeah, I'll go with Willie.
Yeah. No, you're right. He said it. So Willie Nelson came out just recently and said that he was not going to be smoking. He will do edibles and wax, but for health reasons, yeah, he's 90. And he's
inhaling
hot. So he smokes.
Yeah. Now that I think about it a little bit more, yeah, his lungs are probably dying of 90 years of smoking marijuana, you know?
Yeah. Well, hey, he's still kicking, and he's been smoking
weed.
Hell
yeah. High five, THC, CBD.
I'll take it. Damn, still a close one. I thought that one was going to go C-Money's way. JB, he's a smart guy. All right. Here we go. Early September this year, big-time comedy legend was almost killed in a car accident, okay, when his classic vehicle being driven by a friend was driven into a ditch, actually breaking several parts of this guy's spine. Was it A, Eddie Murphy, B, Tracy Morgan, C, Dave Chappelle, or D, Kevin Hart?
See money?
See money.
I concede the floor to you.
Tracy Morgan.
You're gonna go Tracy Morgan.
I have to agree, even though I know that Kevin Hart just got into a car accident recently and got seriously hurt as well. But the answer to your question is Tracy Morgan.
No, you're both wrong. It was Kevin Hart. Tracy Morgan got hit years ago in a bus accident, and Kevin Hart just recently in his classic car landed in a
That
was your opportunity.
No, I do that. I did that always in high school. I read like the first two sentences, first two letters, you know, first two words of the sentence and answered the question. They gotta wait till it's over, man. Gotta read the whole question.
Yeah, yeah. All right, here's another one. See money, here's another chance because this one we did not talk about on the show. In April of this year, scientists in the University of Tel Aviv actually successfully printed the first 3D version of this organ using cells and human tissue. So this is a fully working organ, miniature version. Was it A, a set of lungs, B, a kidney, C, a heart, or D, a penis?
Oh, man. All of those, I'm sure, are very real.
Yeah, but I'm thinking which one's the hardest, like, because there's definitely one where it's probably impossible to do still at this point. Which one?
I think the lungs are actually harder than the heart. I'm going to go with the lungs.
The penis is hardest if we're talking about organs.
That's what she said. All
right, sorry.
I'm going to go with kidney because I feel like if they 3D printed a heart, that would be world news, right? Like, that must be the rarest thing to get from somebody.
Sure. So, C-Money says heart. C-Money
says
kidney. JB?
Yeah.
I said the lungs. I feel like the heart's already been done.
It actually is a heart. It was the heart. Yes. So again, no points for either of you guys. Crazy.
Yeah, that is crazy.
We're getting closer and closer to being able to manufacture organs. You ever seen Repo Man?
Yes. Yeah. Make sure you pay your bills, ladies and gentlemen. Come get that.
Dude, it was what, 150, 200 years ago. If you got a fractured bone, compound fracture, you were probably dead.
Yeah, you're done.
Now we're printing organs. I mean,
we're going to in like 50 years, we're going to answer the question of like mortality. We're like an extra 100 years. I feel like.
Yeah, I feel like our grandkids are probably going to be able to live well into their hundreds.
Well into their hundreds. Yes, I agree. Yep.
All right, last question. Let's see if C-Money can tie it late, or if JB can solidify his victory with the nail in the coffin. Gentlemen, what was the last state to legalize recreational marijuana? in 2019? Was it A, New Hampshire, B, Illinois, C, New Mexico, or D, Pennsylvania?
C, money?
Like JB has the slightest advantage.
I call collusion because you're. This is a question to a guy who has a weed news segment that tunes yes. in. Tunes
I feel
up
a
up.
Lot of pressure. I feel a lot
That's
of pressure.
That's the thing. That's, that was my thing.
I'm ashamed of myself
he should
already.
Know, but he probably doesn't.
I'm ashamed of myself already because I just blew three chances on these questions. Apologies, yeah. Trivia would not be, or Jeopardy or Wheel of Fortune would not be my forte. I'm going to go with Illinois.
Okay.
I'm going to have to agree. Again, I feel a lot of pressure, but I do believe it is Illinois.
You bastard. It was Illinois.
Yeah.
So even though C-Money guessed right, great job.
Damn it.
JB great. Just knew when you know, you know. What can I say?
Yes.
Well, damn. It was a close
and that
one,
does
but.
It. That's right. I'm the champ.
Speech.
Thank you very much. That's me. Another win, another W for JB Perez. What can I say, C-Money? It's not your thing, it's my thing. I would like to thank WJHM102Jams.com for housing this championship run. To all our fans out there who continue to listen to us, if you're listening to us on Spreaker too, thank you so much. There, hashtag Weed Wednesdays, guys. 2019 is almost done. We're gonna keep doing this through 2020 because we're the Potheads at the Potheads Web Show and all the social media platforms. Just Google us. Thank you guys so much. We gotta get out of here. We're right on time, so I'll take it with us at Potheads JB is my social media platform. Get at me. I'm gonna get back on that horse there. Yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Frank the Tank.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It's Jimmy Buffett, and it's 420, guys. So make sure that you smoke with us every Wednesday. Hashtag Weed Wednesdays on WJHM102Jams.com, 7 p.m. Or look for us everywhere you get your podcast. We're doing our thing, guys, and we're trying to grow. So show some support. Follow us. Tell your friends and family about us at the Podheads Web Show. That's PODHEADS. See money.
Thank you for joining in, guys. Till next week, we appreciate it as always. Don't forget to reach out on social media and tell people you know. Word of mouth always helps us. At the Potheads Web Show, at Megan C Money for all your food munchy needs. Let me know what you guys cook out there. I'm always interested. Until next week.
Peace yeah. out, y'all.
All I wanna do is get my nails done. That's all I wanna do. That's all I wanna do. All I wanna do is get my nails done, home. That's all I wanna do. That's all I wanna do. It's Sunday afternoon. I got one thing on my mind. Manicure, pedicure, my nails looking fine. Luscious berry on my fingertips. Nail polish and brush, I come equipped.
Aw, Dad, my computer's slow again and I can't play my games.
Call Your Computer Solutions today and we will scan for viruses and clean that computer up remotely and make it fast again. Our phone number's 407-826-0810.
Thanks, Dad, my computer's fast again. Now I can do my homework. Thanks for calling Your Computer Solutions at 407-826-0810.
CDavidSmithLaw.com.
You can call him at 407-801-2667.
Wait, you are not Chuck.
My dad can help when people get hurt. He loves to help people.
If you are ever injured at work or in a car accident, you should call my friend Chuck.
You can call him at 407-801-2667.
That website again is CDavidSmithLaw.com.
Offices, Orlando.
Does it actually have that much W's?
The Ted Beard Show would like to thank one of our awesome sponsors, StarChannelUS.com. These guys are very, very cool. They bring 21st century surface drainage solutions to reality. They can do corporate and government work. These are the guys that make roads and bridges safe in the rain. You can see all about them at StarChannelUS.com. That website again is StarChannelUS.com. Oak Ridge Gun Range is a family-oriented shooting range that has been in business for over 30 years. They specialize in basic firearm training and offer numerous services such as consignments, gun trades, gunsmithing, and concealed weapon classes. I even got my training for gun safety at Oak Ridge Gun Range. Great customer service, and firearm safety is what they do best. So find out more